youth group games we really like to do. Now they're on the internet, so you can play them also.
Although the origins of Deathball are still somewhat of a mystery to us, we do know that it has something to do with this man.
Okay, for this game, you're going to need to create a circle of chairs. Make sure that you have one chair per player, minus one, because you're always going to have one player in the middle. Oh, and you'll need a ball. Once you have that all set, you're ready to play. One player on the edge of the circle starts with the ball, while the player who's it stands in the center of the circle. To begin the game, the server throws it to somebody else in the circle. Now, if you're the last person to touch the ball, and the person in the middle tags you, then you're now in the middle. Also, if the person in the middle gets a hold of the ball, whoever touched the ball last is now in the middle. Okay, now that you have general gameplay down, here are some other rules. When starting the game, you cannot serve it directly to the player next to you. You do have to start the game by serving it to somebody else in the circle, but remember, this rule only counts at the beginning of each round. Okay, the last rule is that if the ball doesn't touch you, you cannot go chase it outside of the circle. The only people who should be chasing a loose ball are the person who touched the ball last and the person in the center. Deathball is a fast-paced, high-energy game. It plays best with 10 or more people. You can play with less, but make sure you spread the circle out a little bit bigger. Have fun with it, and don't be afraid to make modifier rules specific to your group. Thanks for watching. We hope you have fun trying this game out with your group. My name is Chris, and this is Ben.
Youth group games we really like to do. Now they're on the internet, so you can play them also.